is going on? This is Anokhi The One, and I'm back with another video. This video is actually about my unpopular thoughts about Robyn Crawford and Whitney Houston. So it's all about sleeping with the enemy. And before you start to judge, I want you to see a video from The Matrix. This is why I love The Matrix, because there's so many principles that are true and that you can see in real life, but if you don't understand the laws, like from reading all these different books and things like that, then you may miss it. And I don't want you guys to miss this powerful message with this whole topic. So I'm gonna run that clip right now.
You have to understand, most of these people are not ready to be unplugged. And many of them are so inert, so hopelessly dependent on the system, that they will fight to protect it. Were you listening to me, Neo? Or were you looking at the woman in the red dress?
I was...
Look again. Freeze it.
This isn't The Matrix.
No. It's another training program designed to teach you one thing. If you are not one of us, you are one of them.
What are they?
Sentient programs. They can move in and out of any software still hardwired to their system. That means that anyone we haven't unplugged is potentially an agent. Inside The Matrix, they are everyone and they are no one.
So, I want you to think about this story as Whitney Houston is Neo, because of her purpose. It has nothing to do with male or female or anything like that. So Whitney Houston had a huge purpose when she came into the music industry, when she became a singer. It wasn't just she wants to be some superstar. She had a very strong purpose, and I never heard that part of it before I started to watch these interviews from Robyn Crawford, right? So before, like, you know, before, superstar, amazing singer, and then as time went on, like around the mid-2000s, it became crack and Bobby Brown. Like, her entire legacy became crack and Bobby Brown, till this day, right? And so now with this new element of it, a lot of people are saying, you know, her friend betrayed her, and, you know, why now, and all these different things, and what is the purpose of it? So I want you guys to think about this entire situation from the clip that I just showed you. This is a matrix reality. It has been created for us to see. These spiritual laws that I talk about are invisible laws. So you can't use visible things and labels and societal norms to understand these stories. So that's why I feel like this is such a powerful story that I feel like a lot of people are probably gonna miss, but I'm gonna tell you what I think. And I have been seeing angel numbers. I saw 1111 just now before I turned the camera on. And when I thought about, when I saw the picture of it this morning with her and Lena Waithe, I've been seeing 1111 everywhere. So just know that. Okay, so I told you that Whitney Houston is Neo. All right, so from these interviews that I've been watching, Robyn Crawford talks about how everything started and what her role was, right? So I didn't know anything about Robyn Crawford at all whatsoever before I started to watch the interviews, but I knew about Bobby Brown. Everybody knows about Bobby Brown, Whitney Houston, okay? So we can't judge by these markers, right? The marker of, okay, Bobby Brown, he's a famous black male entertainer. That should be the perfect couple, right? That should be the perfect situation. They should mesh well, and she should explode her career, and it should be greater, right? Then you have this other person, Robyn Crawford, childhood friend. She's probably just Whitney Houston's gay best friend, and, you know, Whitney Houston probably just threw her a job because she loves her friend. She wanted to be around her friend, right? This is what the Matrix will show you. This is what the Matrix will tell you. And if you're thinking in terms of inside matrix thinking, that's all you'll think, right? And that's why I think it's powerful for people to tell their story, right? But if you watch the interviews, Robyn talks about how
Whitney said to me one day, she came to my house and she said, you know, I don't think we should be physical. Mm-hmm. And because where we're going, if people found out about it, they would just use it against us. It's kind of like fuel for the fire. Mm-hmm. It was the 80s, and that's how it was. You were either this or that. Women were treated. You couldn't see two of your favorite female artists on the same ticket. That was like a far-fetched dream. And I think spiritually, for her and her belief, everyone knows Whitney gave a testimony before every award show who she gave her thanks to. And she was steadfast and steady on that. She never wavered. I took her lead. I chose to love her unconditionally.
And she
gave you the
Bible.
I didn't really know what that word meant. Yes, she gave me a Bible. It was in a box, and she gave me a Bible. Mm-hmm. And she said, love me unconditionally. And I aspire to do that. And that's why I could sit here now. That woman's spirit is like this.
Robyn took the position, and she became the position of the gatekeeper. And this is very interesting because from my studies of ancient African tribes and also Native American tribes, there are two-spirit people. They call them two-spirit people in Native American culture, African-American culture, I'm not sure, or African, ancient African culture, I'm not sure what they call it, but basically it's the equivalent of LGBT of today, right? They're the spiritual gatekeepers. So they're in tune with the spiritual world. Almost like when you think about how cats were worshipped because they were in both worlds at the same time. They're in the physical realm, but very much in the spiritual realm at the same time. So that's how ancient African tribes viewed LGBT, because a lot of times they're androgynous, they can see both male and female energies, and they're also, you know, aware of the spiritual world, spiritual realms, right? So they can feel people, feel energies and things like that. So she literally said when Whitney Houston had to go into a meeting or anything like that, she would get there 15 minutes early to fill out the energy, right? And she's not like a bouncer. She's not a big dude that's just gonna fight physically, that's gonna beat someone up. She's a spiritual gatekeeper. So 15 minutes before, she's filling out the energy. If the energy's off, Whitney, I don't think this is a good idea. Maybe we should try something else. You can still come to the meeting, but just know this is the energy that I'm picking up. Da, 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 da. You can't get to Whitney Houston without going through Robyn Crawford. That was her gatekeeper. And from the time when she was a teenager until she exploded, Robyn Crawford was her gatekeeper. She was there along the way, every single place that she went. That was her protection. That was her, like a guardian angel. But because of how we've been conditioned, most people aren't going to see her as that. People are going to assume and they're going to say, oh, she's just gay. You completely take all the spiritual realm out of it because your spirit is not gay. It's not straight. It's not woman. It's not man. It's not black. It's not white. It's a spirit. You judge. It says, what is the quote? You will know them by their fruit. You will know them by their fruit. Judge the tree by the fruit. A good tree bears good fruit. Has nothing to do with any of that other stuff, right? So think about that when I'm talking. So all this is going on. So now Bobby Brown comes into the picture, right? And like I said, mind you, this entire rise, this huge rise to fame. So many people will give credit to Clive Davis. They'll give credit to, you know, they'll give credit to the producers. They'll give credit to this person, that person, that person. But completely devoid the power of the gatekeeper, right? Completely, right? And gatekeeper, if you're a gatekeeper out there, y'all need some credit, and hopefully I'm able to give you some credit out there. That is the true definition of a gatekeeper. A lot of people think a gatekeeper is someone who is famous and who has the power to say, you're gonna be successful or you're not gonna be successful. No, a true gatekeeper is someone who loves you unconditionally. They have spiritual abilities. They are aware spiritually. They're spiritually attuned to where they can feel energies and have that discernment to know this is a bad deal, this is a good deal, this is probably a good decision, like this person has good energy, this person doesn't have good energy. That's a gatekeeper, okay? And that's why now with this spiritual awakening, people are becoming more aware. And that's why these types of gatekeepers are even more important now, because the door is open, right? We have YouTube. I'm talking to you guys on YouTube. Like, before, nobody would ever hear my thoughts, right? So, anyways, to the point that I was about to make, okay? Bobby Brown comes into the picture. Now, most of you, when I showed you that first clip, you probably assumed that that woman in the dress that I showed, the red dress, was Robyn Crawford, right? But in reality, in my thoughts, from what I know spiritually and just intellectually, if you stop thinking about male, female, gay, straight, all this other stuff, Bobby Brown was more like that woman in the red dress, right? He was the agent, right? Look, you know, perfect, good looking, right? Rich, famous, everybody loves him, all the women love him, and all this sounds like a good thing. It sounds great in the media and all this stuff. Whitney Houston, Bobby Brown, right? But that was the enemy. She's literally sleeping with the agent. So what happens when you are a powerful person, you're Neo, right? You're trained, you're talented, you're all this other stuff. You have this strong purpose. You have your trinity, you have your gatekeeper who, you know, before you come in the door, they're filling out the energy, make sure everything goes good. And then you walk in through the door and magic happens, right? Then the agent comes, right? Nobody is for sure whether this person is an agent or if this person is legit or whatever the case may be, right? And this agent starts to bypass the gatekeeper.
Bobby Brown and Robyn Crawford together was the equivalent of fire and water, petrol and a short fuse. They hated each other.
Robyn felt that Bobby was a bad influence. She really and truly felt he was a bad influence and that he would destroy her.
Right? We've seen this. I see this no different than people always talk about how NBA stars and all these famous men or whatever, they will rise to fame with a particular woman, 9 times out of 10, a gatekeeper. And then once they get famous, they drop off the gatekeeper and then they are with the enemy. Then they're sleeping with the enemy and their entire career goes down, right? I don't see this situation as any different. The agent bypasses the gatekeeper. Makes fun of the gatekeeper, like annoys the crap out of the gatekeeper.
He had a way of just like, you just never knew when he was gonna perform, and that's what I call it.
Perform.
You know, he was gonna show
abusive.
Out.
Abusive. Mm-hmm.
Well, just show out, just anywhere we could be.
And I'm gonna show this quick clip of like Bobby Brown and Robyn Crawford, like how he's literally trying to humiliate her in public and separate her from Whitney Houston.
Rob, this is
There were numerous fights between Robyn and Bobby Brown. Serious fights. Bobby and Robyn had some physical altercations. And I think there were times when he wasn't always the winner. Yes. Yes.
So, as you can see, that is annoying as hell, right? But that is a perfect picture of, like, how the agent will come and try to destroy, you know, a bond that is literally protecting you from evil, is protecting you on your way up, right? And to the point where it's like, okay, well, you're gonna have to make a decision between me and her because we're not getting along. They literally would fight physically, like the guy said. And so if you are Neo, and think about the movie. If you've seen The Matrix, if you haven't seen The Matrix, you need to. Think about the movie, right? So, if you have this gatekeeper, you have this trinity, right? Because in my thoughts, Robyn Crawford is the trinity of Neo, which is Whitney Houston, right? You have this agent who is trying to, fighting for Neo's time, right? Fighting for Neo's time, fighting for Neo's energy, and wants to be in the position of Trinity, right? And get in the way, but it's actually the enemy. It's actually the agent in disguise, okay? Then slowly but surely things will deteriorate.
Was Bobby physically abusive to her? From what I understand, yes. Bobby saved his worst behavior for when I wasn't around.
You laying in the bed with the enemy and they're talking about your Trinity, right? And you're going on along with it because you just want peace in your home and all this other stuff. And they're in your head, right? And slowly but surely you spend less time with your gatekeeper, you spend less time with your Trinity.
She was isolated.
Got you.
She became isolated, mm-hmm. That's what I would say. Because mm-hmm. They were together. Isolated. Mm. So I didn't see as much of her as I used to or needed to.
Right? And then you're more susceptible to evil, to different things coming to you because you don't have that gatekeeper. Instead of like at times where you would have your gatekeeper, at times where you have your Trinity go in 15 minutes before, right? Now you have a Bobby Brown. And he 15 minutes late on drugs. Tripping, right? Or you're like, no, we don't need you, Robin. I got Bobby, he's gonna come and you know, handle. This fool, I'm not gonna say fool because I don't know Bobby Brown like that. But Bobby Brown is a Neo of his matrix. Whitney Houston is a Neo of her matrix. That's where people have to understand things. He's not completely wrong, period. He just might have been wrong for her. He's a Neo of his matrix. She's a Neo of her matrix. So he needs a Trinity for his matrix. She needs a Trinity for her matrix, right? That's where things get messed up. So Bobby Brown, maybe he might even be jealous.
When did it start to go wrong? Can there be too much passion? Can there be too much? Yeah.
Yeah, it can clash. Mm-hmm. After the bodyguard?
After? Well, that was early.
I think somewhere inside, something happened to a man when a woman has that much control or has that much fame.
Yeah. If he doesn't have his own. Has to have his own. Was he jealous of you?
He's not gonna like this, but yes.
Mm-hmm. He might have all kinds of issues going on because he is a Neo. He's not a Trinity for her. Right? So he's coming in the meetings and, yeah, they're cool. Come on, let's go. Oh, $100,000, you gonna offer $100 million? Come on, get it. Come, yeah, let's go. We need some money. Come on. And like, right? Cause you have the wrong person in the wrong position, right? And so over time that keeps happening to the point where in 2000, Robin was just like, forget it. I'm out. Like, I'm not about to continue to probably destroy. That's a lot of spiritual weight to carry when you know you're a gatekeeper. You know what your position is. You know how much you love this person unconditionally, but they're allowing the agent to get in between you and keep building a distance. And you're getting into situations that now this person has to clean up, but if you had her in the right position, you wouldn't have had to clean it up in the first place.
When Robin left, John finally had total control.
She loved her daddy, and she trusted him, but that allowed for a lot of foxes to come in the hen house.
She seemed to be a bit of an ATM for a lot of people that I saw around her.
I don't see how an accountant, you know, drives a Ferrari and has a yacht and only has one client.
Was John himself stealing money?
She found out about it. All the money he stole, she hated it. She cut him off.
Like, people say, why now? Why this? Why that? Whatever, right? I feel like this is a story. And I think when I see stories of very powerful people and things like that, I see this no different than stories in the Bible. These are stories that we can learn from. There are spiritual laws. That's why I feel like we should read more biographies. Like, there are so many spiritual laws that we can learn from. We don't have to make the mistakes all the time. Sometimes you can learn from other people's mistakes, right? And so, like, after all that, right? Bobby Brown, they come out with their memoir, him and Whitney Houston's mom, and they touch on Robin, and they say what they feel about her, and she's never said anything, right? And people are like, why now, why now? Well, people are talking about her, why she can't tell her story. And like, I feel like it's very valid and it's very powerful, because I would have never, like, for me, I would have never thought anything else of Whitney Houston besides she was, she rose to fame so powerfully and was destroyed by drugs and by a Brown. But then there's a whole other element of it, right? How did she got there in the first place? That's the missing link in how it happened. Bobby Brown says that after all this, she died, things like that. He comes out talk about, well, if Robin would have never left, she'd probably be here to this day, right? Whitney Houston would probably be here to this day. But at the same time, like, you literally pushed her out. And by 2000, she was just like, I'm out, right? And then Whitney Houston didn't have any protection, right? Yes, you can pray and things like that. But when God sends you somebody like that, and you disobey God, it's so interesting how people see things, right? When you disobey the laws of the universe, when you've brought this person in, Whitney Houston had the, she had a decision that she could have made, right?
Robin gave her an ultimatum. It's gonna be me or him.
She could have took the red pill and the blue pill. And it's so, like, her energy is very powerful to the fact that I, to the point where I feel it. I feel pulled. Like, I could not end the day without making this video. I feel pulled to say this because I feel like so many people are gonna miss it, right? She had a decision. Red pill, blue pill.
Whitney said, tell her that I accept her resignation.
And at that moment in 2000, she could have said, you know what? From what I've observed, from what everybody is observing, this person that I've been choosing, this blue pill that I've been taking, which is Bobby Brown, right? And you can't blame him completely, of course, but she had a decision, right? I'm taking this blue pill. Every day you have different decisions that are red pill, blue pill decisions. This is blue pill. Regardless of religion, I have to search that on myself, for myself, because a lot of the stuff that goes against homosexuality in the Bible, that I have a book right here, what the Bible really says about homosexuality, that debunks all the seven. There's only like seven scriptures that even try to say anything about homosexuality, and they can easily be debunked. And that's going to be another video for another day. But she could have took a red pill or a blue pill, right? Like, I think what, like, he says she could, what would have happened basically if she would have not left? Well, she would have been going through a lot of more torment because she keeps taking that blue pill. Well, what if she decided to take the red pill, right? What if in that moment in 2000, she said, you know what? Bobby Brown, you are not the person for me. I'm done. Robin, let's go. But what, like, think about that. Like, what? Who would Whitney Houston be today if she chose to take that red pill, which I feel like Robin was her trinity, if she took that red pill, because the world was being, like, primed to accept her, right? Because in 1997, Ellen came out of the closet, right? She came out on television, and her entire career went to trash. People forget about that part. Her entire career went to trash for 6 years, right? But after that 6 years, she got the Ellen Show, and she's the most famous lesbian woman on the planet. And she's far more famous than a lot of people, just period. She's one of the most famous people in the entire world, right? But she took that red pill. She could have took the blue pill. She could have said, you know what, I'm gonna keep it secret, keep it. But she chose to take that her truth. The red pill is about your truth, because your truth is not gonna be the same as somebody else's truth, right?
Whitney was at the top of the charts. She had 7 consecutive number one records. She was everywhere. Her favorite saying was, can I be me? I have made all these people happy.
Thank you so much.
And I still can't be me. Can I be me?
Whitney Houston actually died from a broken heart.
You gotta know who you are before you step into this business. You'll probably wind up being somebody that you don't even like. If she were an artist today, she probably would still be here.
Whitney Houston took the blue pill, kept taking the blue pill, right? And at that moment, she could have took the red pill. She could have stayed in her truth and said, you know what? I am in love. I have a deep relationship with this person. And this person has bared nothing but good fruit. This person over here has bared nothing but bad fruit. This person is uncomfortable. It's not going to be comfortable for the world. My entire career might be trash for some years. It might be trash forever, but this person has consistently bared good fruit. I'm gonna take this red pill. It doesn't sound right, it doesn't look right, but I'm gonna take the red pill. Where would she be, right? Even Robyn Crawford now, like, she, if you look at the poise that she has, the calm, like, she's in a marriage that she seems to be happy. You can't judge from the outside, but she seems to be in a happy marriage with children. Like, Bobby Brown, I don't know. He trying to get his life together, whatever. But even the children that you make with the, when you take in the blue pill, the children that you create from the enemy, like, that curses your children when you don't make the right decisions as far as choosing the enemy, the Trinity, because now you're bound by marriage, then you're bound by a child. I'm gonna leave y'all with this clip, and you tell me who you think is the Trinity and who was the enemy in this situation. All right, love you guys, and I'm out.
That's why I have to go.
Why?
Because I believe in something.
What?
I believe I can bring him back. Doing?
Going with you.
No, you're not.
No? Let me tell you what I believe. I believe Morpheus means more to me than he does to you. I believe if you are really serious about saving him, you are going to need my help. And since I am the ranking officer on this ship, if you don't like it, I believe you can go to hell. Because you aren't going anywhere else. Tank, load us up.